Hello everyone, I'm Nidhi Sekho, an art educator and author for art theory books from classes 9 to 12th. So CBSE has introduced a big change. Now in class 12th fine arts, our syllabus is divided into two terms in both practical as well as theory. In this video, we'll try and understand how to go about the new syllabus, what to do in theory and practical, what is deleted, and we'll also discuss MCQs related to Rajasthani school and the introductory part of Pal school, Jain school and schools of Central India. And before I start, please subscribe to my channel so that whatever new comes, whatever is uploaded, you get notifications. This is an image of the CBSE circular uploaded in which they talk about the two terms. Just look at the yellow part. The question paper will have multiple choice questions, that is MCQs, including case-based MCQs and MCQs on assertion reasoning type. During the test, the duration of test will be 90 minutes and it will cover only the rationalized syllabus of term 1 only. That is approximately 50% of the entire syllabus. So now we need to be more thorough with the reading of our theory so that we can answer the multiple choice questions. And another thing is you have to answer these MCQs on OMR sheets. So you have to be very careful when you blacken your circles, otherwise you will lose marks. So this is the new syllabus. The term 1 includes Rajasthani, Pahari, Mughal and Deccan schools of miniature painting. Six limbs are gone, elements and principles of art are gone. So, but this brief introduction to Indian miniature schools, that is Western Indian, Pal, Rajasthani, Mughal, Central India, Deccan and Pahari are still there. In Rajasthani school, method and material are gone, they are deleted, and Raja Anirudh Singh Hara painting is also now deleted. Though elements, principles and six limbs are no longer part of theory syllabus, they are still very important. One, because they are the foundation of art, and two, they are very important for Viva. External examiner will definitely ask questions from elements and principles, especially color theory. So please go through them from your books. I have also made videos on them and color theory has been done in detail. Further on, method and material for all schools have been deleted. In Pahari school, everything else is there. In Mughal school, the birth of Saleem painting is deleted. And in Deccan school, the painting of Ragini Patham Shikha is no more there. This is term 2. Paintings are also deleted in term 2, but we'll not do that in detail in this video. We'll do that later. This is the image for Fine Arts Practical. In term 1, you are going to have painting composition. It is for 35 marks and for your exam will be for 25 marks and your portfolio will be for 10 marks. In portfolio, first is record of the term performance from sketch to finished product, which is 5 marks. Then one selected work based on any folk art form, which is 2 marks. And then two selected works of paintings done during the term, which is going to be for 3 marks. So total minimum 3 you have to put in your portfolio. Now just look at the text box on the left. In portfolio, the medium is going to be water or poster colors. In folk art, you can do any painting on Varli, Madhubani, Gond, Kalamkari, Fat painting or any Patchitra. You can explore, you can Google many art forms and just see what you want to make in your portfolio. Varli and Madhubani are very common, so now you can explore new areas also. In life and nature, what we need to do is it's plant study, animal study, human study, any outdoor or indoor activities of people with minimum 3 human figures in action. CBSE says the compositions can be made on affairs of family, friends and daily life, games and sports activities, nature, fantasy, which means now you can make abstracts also, national, religious, cultural, historical and social events and celebrations. The size of the paper that you need to take is A2 or what you call half imperial. It is a cartridge sheet or a buff sheet. Now I am including a few images of Indian folk art forms. The first one is Varli, which is from Maharashtra. The second one is Madhubani. Moving on, you can also see the folk art forms of other states. This is now Gond. Which is Madhya Pradesh, then Kalamkari is down south, Andhra Pradesh and adjoining areas. Then this is Patchitra painting, the upper one is from Odisha and the one on the right below is Kalighat. So all these things you can go through and just see which folk art form you like. But you have to remember, now this is plus 2. According to the difficulty level, according to your own level, 5th subject students do it very well. The 6th subject students can do the basic part, but please go through the folk art forms and make them accordingly. This is plant study, which also comes under nature study. You can take a branch of a tree or any leaves or a twig and then sketch it like the one given in the first. You can do details. You can start from pencil to charcoal and then move on to pencil colors and pastel colors in your sketchbook. Just go however you want and experiment the way you can. Six subject students from science who have been given this as extra subject might find it taxing, but try and do it in your leisure time. It will be good break for you. These are two images of animal study, which also comes under nature study. You can sketch a dog, any kind of fauna that you see around you, any animals that you see, or your own pets also. These are a few images of human study from live sketching. You can start with 7.5 heads and then sketch different people in your sketchbook. You can sketch your own family. Then slowly you can proceed to more figures. You can use historical monuments in the background. You can use nature. You can use market scenes, small things you can add in your composition. Like CBSE says, you can do family scenes, games, sports activities, nature, fantasy, national importance, cultural importance, scenes of festivals, social events and celebrations. Anything can be put into painting composition. But remember, you have to do at least three figures as main, and the rest you can put in background and create a beautiful perspective with the help of watercolors or poster colors. All that you do in your practical has to be presented to the external examiner. So you have to compile them properly into a nice presentable folder. You can buy a presentation file from the market, or you can use your own DIY and make a portfolio using a recycled paper or whatever skills that you are up to. So in that portfolio, you have to put three things mandatory. That is one folk art and two life and nature works done in water and poster colors. For six subject students, things are made a little easy. So you can talk to your own teacher and ask how much is required. For fifth subject students, for the main subject students, sketchbooks and classworks from sketch to a finished work in different media, that is pencil, charcoal, pen, pastels, watercolors, poster colors and acrylic colors. All these things have to be included nicely into the portfolio, which is presented to the external examiner in presence of your own teacher, that is the internal examiner. Let's go through the multiple choice questions. First is, which two religions were Pal school and Western school based on? Pal school was all about Buddhism, and Western school, that is Jain school, was all about Jainism. So answer is B, Buddhism and Jainism. Next, Kalpasutra and Kalkacharya Katha are the painted manuscripts of which of the following schools? They are both Jain texts and they belong to answer C, Jain school. Which is the most prominent center of Western Indian school of painting or Jain school? We can eliminate the wrong answers here. Nalanda and Vikramshila were for Pal school. Jodhpur is the sub-school of Rajasthani miniature. So we are left with Gujarat. The Jain school had main centers in Gujarat, few parts of Rajasthan and few parts of Central India. So our answer is B. Now next, which of the following is an example of a palm leaf manuscript? That means the perfection of wisdom written in 8000 lines. Chaurpanchika and Lorchan A and B were for Central India. Sangrahini Sutra was a Jain text, so we are left with C. Asta Sahasrika Prajnaparamita, which was made under Rampal, the Pal school king, under whose reign this was written and illustrated. What is the base material of the manuscript paintings found in Pal and Western schools? This is easy. The answer is A, palm leaves. Next one, which school has the prominent characteristic feature of father eye protruding in its human figures? Pal school had Ajanta influence. It was done very beautifully. Deccan and Pahadi miniatures. These are the miniature paintings. So we are left with Jain school. And if you remember, this is a very prominent characteristic feature with which you can identify Jain school instantly. They used to make this father eye protruding. So our correct answer is D, Jain school. Which of the following are the main examples of paintings of Central India, including the Sultanate school? A, Sangrahani Sutra and Uttardhan Sutra were Jain texts. C, Kalpa Sutra and Kalkacharya Katha were also Jain texts. Ragmala and Baramasa were done later in Central School. So the main ones which were done including the Sultanate School are B, Chaurpanchika and Nimbatnama. Nimbatnama was mainly done under Khalji dynasty in Sultanate period. The next one, the style of manuscript painting was vigorously distorted. So we have to fill in this blank. If you remember the main features in Jain school, if you remember, the anatomy was very distorted. They used to make things larger or smaller according to the space given. So the proportion, the illustrations were not done properly. And this is the main characteristic feature of Jain school. Our correct answer is B, Jain school. Name the technique used after coloring in which a stone is rubbed at the back of the painting for smooth shine and blending of all layers. This is no longer part of your syllabus, but since it's general knowledge, we can see it. A khadiya is the white pigment. Vasli is the name of the paper. Burnishing is the right answer here because this is the technique the statement is talking about. Mounting is almost like framing. So C, burnishing is the correct answer. Next one, in which medium the Rajasthani miniature paintings are made? This is one of the questions from the old papers. The answer here is watercolors. That is C. Which are the main centers of Pal School of Painting? Nalanda and Vikramshila is the right answer because Gujarat is for Jain school, Malwa is for Central Indian paintings and Jodhpur is a Rajasthani sub-school. So our answer is A, Nalanda and Vikramshila. The next one, which are the main centers of Central Indian school of painting? This we discussed. Malwa region was the main center where these paintings were made. Who coined the term Rajput paintings to refer to the Rajasthani miniatures? B, C, Jagat Singh and Bhav Singh were rulers for Rajasthani sub-schools. They did not write anything on art history. B, N. Goswami is the professor emeritus of Punjab University, Chandigarh and is very popular for his research on Pahadi miniatures. A, Anand Kumar Swami is the correct answer here. He was a Ceylonese art historian. Ceylon is the earlier name for Sri Lanka. He did a lot of research on Indian art and he is the one who coined the term Rajput painting, so A is a correct answer. What are Vaslis? This is also a method and material question. Vaslis are layered thin sheets of handmade paper, so A, C and D are wrong and our correct answer is B. For which of the options do the following statements hold true? The first one, the depiction of nature is simply ornamental in Rajasthani miniatures. So where do we see nature in any of the miniatures? Maru Ragini has desert and a small arch on top. Chogan Players has absolutely flat background. Radha Bani Thani is a portrait and background is again flat. So our correct answer is Krishna on Swing, that is Bikaner sub-school, in which we see in the lower panel there are two trees and they have been done in a stylized manner and nature is simply ornamental because it is enhancing the overall appeal and overall theme of the painting. Moving on, Rajasthani artists used bright glowing colors with flat background. Now, which of the following has flat background? Chogan Players, Jodhpur, we see a lot of women on horses on a flat background and colors are also bright and glowing. So our correct answer is B, Chogan Players. The Dash School of Painting originated in its former capital Amer, which is located nearest to the Mughal capitals. The Mughal capitals were Delhi, Agra and Fatehpur Sikri. And if you look at the map, the area of Amer is closest to these capitals. And if you remember the movie Jodha Akbar, Raja Bharmal married his daughter to King Akbar. And later Raja Jai Singh moved the capital to Jaipur and gave the capital the name after his own name. So our answer here is A, Jaipur. The next question, the place where paintings were made and stored in Jaipur was called Dash. The answer Mandi is from Bikaner. The ateliers of Bikaner were called Mandis. Marammat Khana is a made up word. D, Vasli Ghar is also a made up word. And Surat Khana is our correct answer. If you remember the sub-school Jaipur, you can see the video that I've made on Rajasthani part 1. Raja Jai Singh reorganized Surat Khanas and called Mughal artists there and paintings were made and stored here. So our correct answer is C. Now two very easy ones. In which sub-school is the Maru Ragini painting from your syllabus made? The answer is Mewad. What you can do is just remember that whole table of paintings, sub-schools and artists. Most of the questions, majority of the questions will be asked from that. Now the next one. On which mythological book the famous miniature painting Bharat meets Ram at Chitrakoot is based? This is the question from previous question papers only. Bharat and Ram are from Ramayana and this incident is also from Ramayana. So our correct answer is B, Ramayana. Which of the following are the main reasons that imply towards the popularity of Ram and Krishna themes in miniatures? In this case, you have to identify the correct ones. They can be all the above or you have to choose. So look at it carefully. A, Bhakti movement and Vaishnavism. It's absolutely correct. These both happened at that time. Then religious reforms, they also happened because there were a lot of people who came in like Saint Kabir, Vallabhacharya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Birabai. All these people brought a lot of religious reforms. Then C, literary texts based on their lives. Yes, people, Geet Govind and a lot of other texts based upon lives of Krishna were made. And all these things inspired people to make paintings on these themes. D, rulers forced people to worship them. This is absolutely incorrect. So our answer is A, B, C. So fourth one, A, B, C is the correct answer. Next question is, in Bikaner, studios called Dash were set up where a group of artists worked under the supervision of a master artist. B. Surat Khana is part of Jaipur. Marammat Khana and Wasli Ghar are made up words by the use of words like Marammat and Wasli. So our correct answer is Mandi, because Mandis were set up in Bikaner, which was the name for studios or ateliers. Moving ahead, accounts and numerous inscriptions on Dash paintings make it one of the best documented schools of painting. A. Bikaner had Mandis. Libraries were also set up here so that things could be recorded, and a repository of manuscripts and paintings were also kept in those libraries. So our answer is Bikaner A. Then, a distinctive style with a general tendency to elongate the human form is a part of Dash subschool of Rajasthan. In this case, to answer this question, you have to look at the characteristic features of subschools. And if you look them closely, see Kishangarh is the correct answer, with special reference to paintings of Nihal Chand, where you will realize that the human form is elongated and it really strikes you when you look at his paintings. Therefore, the answer is C, Kishangarh. Now, the last set of questions. Dash writes about her in a poem Bihari Jas Chandrika, which became an inspiration for Nihal Chand's painting of Pani Thani, thus representing a blend of poetry and painting. This is a very interesting subschool, which is Kishangarh. Sawant Singh used to write poetry and he was in love with Pani Thani. Nihal Chand painted them. So our correct answer is B, Sawant Singh. Now last, match tables and choose correct answer from the options given below. Radha Pani Thani was done by Nihal Chand. Krishna on Swing was painted by Nuruddin. Maru Ragini was painted by Sahibdin. And Chogan Players was made by Dana. So our correct answer is 3rd, 1B, 2D, 3C and 4A. Rajasthani school is the lengthiest part of this term, and it also includes Pal School, Jain School and schools of Central India. Six limbs, elements and principles have been deleted, but we should know them because there can be some tricky part which can come in exam. So I have included a few bullets that you should remember so that nothing goes wrong and you get full marks. Now first, six limbs of Indian painting. They are in Hindi and if you translate them into English, you will get the meaning. First, Roop, Bhed. Roop is form, Bhed is secret. Praman, measurements, proportion and structure. Bhav is easy, in Hindi it means expression. Lavanya Yojana is scheme of beauty. Sadrishya means resemblance. What has been made should look like the thing that has been made. Then Varnika Bhang is use of brush and colors. Now main manuscript of Pal school. What is Ast Sahasrika Prajna Paramita? If it is translated, it is perfection of wisdom in 8000 lines. It is a fine example of Pal Buddhist palm leaf manuscript with 6 pages of illustrations and wooden covers painted on both sides. It was painted in the monastery of Nalanda in the reign of Pal king Rampal. Then Jain school. Who were the main patrons of Jain manuscripts? The merchant class of Jain community of that time were the main patrons for these manuscripts. Moving on, during exams, till date, there have not been questions on literary texts or questions on any of the patrons or rulers. But now, since it's all MCQs, just play safe and read them once. So first, who composed Geet Govind? Jayadev. It is one of the important subjects, one of the important themes that artists have made. Then who composed Ras Manjari, interpreted as Bouquet of Delight? Bhanu Dutt did it. Then who composed Rasik Priya, translated as The Connoisseur's Delight? Keshav Das did this. Then who penned the poetic work Kavi Priya? Keshav Das did this. Again, who was who has described the 12 months in Baramasa? Again, Keshav Das. So the main text that Keshav Das has done, they are Rasik Priya, Kavi Priya and Baramasa. Then what is Baramasa? It is a part of the 10th chapter of Kavi Priya written for Rai Parbin, celebrated courtesan of Orcha. Orcha is a place. Then, like I said, there have never been questions on patrons, but just read them once from all Rajasthani subschools and you are good to go. So, thank you very much. These are the topics which I have already uploaded. They are elements, principles, six limbs, Pal school, Jain school and schools of Central India and the big one, Rajasthani School of Miniature Paintings. These are the 3 books which you can buy online and links are given in description for all of them. Please like, share and subscribe so that you also get notification. And please comment or whatever update that you get, you can write it so that others and all of us can benefit from this. Thank you very much. Goodbye to you and all the best.